Okay, we're on Bikurim, Perek Aleph, Mishnah Aleph. Bikurim, Aleph, Aleph, we start a new Masechta, Masechet Bikurim. And in order to begin this Masechta, we're just going to have a very short introduction of reading the Psukim in order to understand them, in order to understand the first Mishnah. So, the Psukim, the Mitzvah Bikurim, as we all know, is the Mitzvah to take the first fruits, Bikurim, from Bechor, and to bring them to the Beit HaMikdash and give them to Kohanim. So this is all based on the Torah, explicit Psukim in the Torah. It's very clear. And it's worthwhile to go through them to understand. When you will come to the land that Hashem your God gives you, you inherit it, or you drive out your enemies, and you dwell in it. You should take from the first of all the pri adama, the fruits of the ground that you should bring from your land, v'samta, that the Lord your God gives you, v'samta batan, you place it in a basket. You should go to the place that Hashem will choose to dwell His name there. You go to the Beit HaMikdash. And you go to the Kohen in those days. And you say, I say today to Hashem our God, I've come to the land that the Lord our God has promised to give us. The Kohen takes the basket from your hand, and he places it before the Mizbeach. Then, so this is the mitzvah of bringing Bikurim. Then there's another section. Ve'anita ve'amarta lifnei Hashem Elokecha. Anita here means not to answer, but la'anot. You raise up your voice and you say before Hashem your God. Arami oved avi, vayered mitzrayim, Aramean tried to destroy my father, or whatever. You can look it up. There's many perushim to that pasuk. Vayered mitzrayim, and my forefather went down to Egypt. Vayagartam bimtei ma'at, and he dwelled there bimtei ma'at. Vayisham legoy bimtei ma'at. In small numbers, Vayisham the Goy Gadol Atzum V'Rav, and became a great nation. You might recognize this from the Seder of the Haggadah. Vayareu Otan HaMitzrim, and Vayanunu, the Egyptians were terrible to us, they afflicted us. Vayinu Aleinu Avodah Kasha, they gave us great hard land, hard work. Vanitzak El Hashem Elokei Avoteinu, and we cried out to Hashem, Vayishma Hashem Et Koleinu, Hashem heard our cries. Vayare Onyeinu Vet Amaleinu Vet Lachatzeinu, we saw our toil and our oni, our affliction and our pressure. God took us out of Egypt with a strong arm and an outstretched hand. Over Moraga Dol with great fear and signs and wonders. And he brought us to this place. And he gave us this land, a land of milk and honey. And this is the conclusion. We're still saying this. I brought the reshit, the first fruits of the land that Hashem has given me. And then the pasuk says, "Minachta lifnei Hashem Elokecha, v'ishtachavita lifnei Hashem Elokecha." You place it before God. You bow down before God. You're in the Beit HaMikdash. V'samachta b'chol ha'tov asher natan lecha Hashem Elokecha. You should be happy with all the good that Hashem has given you. Ulebeitecha in your house, atava halevi ve'ager asher b'kirbecha. You, the Levi, the stranger in your midst. So we have two sections, two separate sections. The first is what we call, and the Torah says, mitzvat bikurim. I'm just going to highlight it. Green. That's mitzvah bikurim. This is the actual mitzvah itself. You come, you say, etc., etc., you place, etc., etc. The next is v'anita ve'amarta. You should raise your voice and say, from Arami Oved Avi, I should maybe put a period here. From Arami Oved Avi, this is what Chazal call mikra bikurim. Mikra bikurim means the declaration of bikurim. So we have the mitzvah and we have the declaration. Those are two separate elements that the Torah explicitly states. It's one of the very few mitzvot that when you bring it, the Torah tells you why you bring it and the rationale. It's a very beautiful idea of the idea of Bikurim. Very beautiful, wonderful idea. Nonetheless, there's a two separate mitzvot that the Mishnah is going to talk about. We're going to see this called something called Mivi'im Vikurim. Some people bring and also say Mikra Bikurim. Some Mivi'im Velo Kurim. Some bring Bikurim, but do not say the Mikra Bikurim. And some don't bring at all. Okay, and that's what our Mishnah or the first paragraph are going to talk about. In some way. So that's what the Mishnah we're going to start with. Mishnah Aleph, Perek Aleph, Mishnah Aleph in Bikurim. Says the Mishnah, Yesh Mivi'im Bikurim Bikurim. Some bring Bikurim and say Mikra Bikurim. See, the bartender says Mikra Bikurim. May Arami Ovid Avi Atzof Parsha. That's exactly what we just saw. Arami Ovid Avi. Actually, he says until the end of the Parsha. That's called Mikra Bikurim. Interesting. Samachta B'chol HaTov. Doesn't seem to be part of the Parsha. I'm going to leave it unhighlighted. Well, let's leave it unhighlighted and Interesting question about whether that's part of Mikra Bikurim or not. Okay? Okay, and some Mivi'im, let's go back to the Mishnah. Yesh Mivi'im Bikurim Bikurim. Some bring and say Mikra. Some Mivi'im below Karim bring and some and do not say the Mikra Bikurim. Vyesh Einam Mivi'im. Some people don't bring at all. Eilu She'inam Mivi'im. These are people that don't bring. What are some people that don't bring? Hanotel Letoch Shelo. If I plant, I have a vine. Let's say we're talking about grapes. I have a vine in my field. V'hivrich Letoch Shel Yachid or Shel Rabim. Havracha. What the Bartanura says is what this means is the following. Hivrich letoch shel yachid. This was one of the agricultural techniques that they would use in their time. Chafar guma, I dug a ditch. V'itmin yichur shel ilan, I took a branch of the tree or the vine or whatever, betocha, in the ditch. V'kisal b'afar, and I covered it with dirt. We saw this actually in another Masechtot as well. V'otzi rosh ha-yichur letoch sadeh chaveiro. And I took that, you know, I took that, oh, I'm going to hear. Start over here. I took the ditch and I took it under the ground and I planted it on the ground and then it came up on the other side in my other friend's in the tochset, my other friend's field, or b'shut harabim or the public thoroughfare. V'chein or imatia omedet b'toch shel chaveiro if it's his friend's plant or b'shut harabim or in the public. V'otzi rosh ha-yichur b'toch shelo and then the tree comes up and that's one way they would plant new trees instead of trying with a new sprout and starting from zero. I would take a vine and put it under the ground and it would come up and it would grow on its own and then I would cut it off from the mother tree and it became a new tree. We've seen this in a number of different mestechto. Okay? So the Mishnah says, in that case, this is Eina Mivi'im, Kurim at all from this plant. Okay? So the question is, the question is why not? Two possibilities. One, the Gemara in the Rishami says two possibilities. One is it is a gazlan. He's stealing the sustenance from land that doesn't belong to him. And the other explanation is that according to the Pasuk, we're going to see according to the Pasuk, it says, Mipri Admatcha. Okay, you should, Lakachta Meshi Pri Adama. So we'll see, it's a machloket, we're not going to see, it's a machloket, the Gemara and Yerushalmi, which one is which. Mishnah continues. Hanotea shel letoch shelo, v'ivrich letoch shelo. I plant in my own field. And then I brought a ditch, and then it comes up in my own field. V'derech hayachid, v'derech harabim be'emsa. But somebody else has a path in my field, it's his private path, or it's a public thoroughfare, meaning I have two fields on the side of the road, both sides of the road, and I go under the side of the road, and I, you know, cover the dirt, and I'm mavrich into my new field, and then I graft to the new field. Harei ze eino mevi. And this Mishnah says, eino mevi. Rabbi Yehuda Omer, Rabbi Yehuda says, kaze mevi. No, if it's yours on both sides, then you can bring bikurim from that plant. Nonetheless, we saw this is the example the Mishnah says of Elu she'enam mivi'im, people who have plants and they don't bring bikurim from it. And in the next Mishnah, we'll understand why. If you have any comments or questions, as always, feel free to contact me at rspolter@gmail.com. And we'll dedicate our learning to the memory of my father, Rav Simcha Ben Yitzchak Kalman. Have a good day.